In this video, I'll show you how to do some simple edits on a Physiopedia page. To go into editing mode, we look for this edit drop-down link in the navigation toolbar. Click on it and click edit. This takes the page into an editing mode. You'll see it changes slightly and you'll see this toolbar appear at the top of the page. This toolbar gives us all the functions we need to make edits to the page. So we can simply add some editing text, some new text to the page. Or we can edit any of the text that's already on the page at any point in the page. Then we might want to do some styling or formatting on the page. So all of these icons along the top give us different opportunities to style the text on the page. So I can make it a heading or a subheading. I can make it bold by highlighting it and clicking bold. Italics, underline it. I can also completely clear the styling by clicking this link. And then I can take it back to paragraph text, which is the normal text. Whilst doing this, I seem to have lost the heading formatting on there. All of these options along the top, you can do different things. I can make it a list or a numbered list. I can also make it a link using this link icon by adding a link into the page here. Or I can add a reference at the end by using the reference tool. This is how we do simple editing on the page. At the end of any edits that you've made, it's really important that you save the page, otherwise you'll lose your edits. And I will say that you must save often. Please don't edit a page for long periods of time without saving, because it's likely that you'll lose your edits. So make sure that you save the page often. So I'm just going to go back in now to take this test text away. This is our main editing. Sometimes we'll need to do more complicated editing on the site. And to do that, we go into what's called the source code, which is the code behind Physiopedia. You can access this here under this link, or you can access it here with this link. This will display the source code, which looks quite different and does take a little bit of time to get used to. But once you get used to it, it's a good way to clear up any problems within the text that you're having difficulty editing. Now you can see here, so if you read down through the text, this is the top of the page, and you can see that this is where I added this is some new text. And we made it a link, which is these square brackets around the text, and we also made it a list, which is this hash icon. So what I'm actually going to do is just delete all of that, because that was new and we don't need that to be there. So again, when you're editing the source code, you simply, there's no editing toolbar. I actually never use this toolbar in the source code, but I do just edit the text every now and again. You'll find that it's easier to do it in the source code, but it's not necessary to do it until you get comfortable with editing things in Physiopedia. So as always, we need to save the page at the end. And you'll see that that text has disappeared at the top of the page. So that's simply it, editing a Physiopedia page.